Today we are doing an exhibition called Unearth. Hi, my name is Sharda Kerkar and I run the Museum of Goa. Today we are doing an exhibition called Unearthed, which is a ceramic exhibition with six women ceramists that are based in Goa. The idea of the exhibition is essentially to look at clay and its various possibilities, what are the different forms and how you can use this medium to narrate stories. In our past, we all know that from the Indus Valley civilization and so on, you know, one of the oldest civilizations, we've seen how clay has been unearthed, clay art forms have been unearthed. But it's not just clay that has been unearthed, it was basically history that was narrated through clay. And I think one of the most important reasons why we do such exhibitions is because we want to take contemporary art through different mediums, and in this case specifically ceramics, to the masses, so that there are more and more people who are connected with art, who are connected with contemporary art.
I am Ragini Deshpande and my work is called Verses of the Heart, and it's all to do with the heart and the impermanence of emotions, relationships, and how it, you know, affects our life.
In my works, what I'm looking at, what I'm trying to show, is unearthing of emotions, which moves on to, there are four series altogether. One series, the starting is where we are, there are a lot of emotions that are there in the subconscious level. We kind of get it out and fall into different moods. Second part of it is where life throws a lot of different kind of events, joys, sorrows, everything on you. How you embrace it all with a little dance, and you move on to clay. Basically teaches you how you are centering yourself. So the Dervish Dance series talks about the centering, where all these five pots are talking about the Dervish Dance that you need to arrive to. And that's when you feel the wholeness, the feeling where you are connecting with the universe. So this is the entire series, the story about the entire work.
Hi, my name is Aditi. I'm a ceramic artist and this is my work. This work today is titled Becoming the Banyan, and it is about this harmony with nature that used to exist at some point and now doesn't. They resemble archaeological artifacts to tell this alternate history that seems to have been forgotten. So in my work I combine human body forms with organic nature forms to bring them together and tell this story.
Hello, my name is Avni. I'm a ceramic artist based in Goa. I live in Aldona. These are works that I made for this show. They're like ceramic paintings. They are inspired by the forms or the landscapes of rivers and the kind of sediments they leave behind after the river flows, but things that we don't actually see.
Hi, my name is Nimi, and I have worked on this installation. I've called my installation Ice Age X. Actually, it's like a reflection of my experiences of the last few years and the changes in the landscape of Goa that's happening. So I have tried to bring attention to that through these pufferfish skeletons and the sea bass skeletons, to make a commentary on how every resource in Goa is being overtly extracted. And being here for the last 10 years, being from working from a city earlier, now that I'm here in Goa for the last 10 years, from when I first came to right now, there are so many changes, and it breaks my heart every time, you know, that this adopted homeland, we are just losing all our natural heritage and resources. So yeah, this is what our future looks like to me.
Hi, I'm Tanushree. I'm a ceramic artist based in Goa. I've been here for the last 5 years, and my ceramic journey pretty much started in Goa. This is my first ever exhibition, so I'm quite excited about it. And in this exhibition, I've created a body of work called Memory, which basically explores how memories not just affect our emotions and our mind, but also how they live within our body, how they trigger response, they trigger physical responses, and how it affects who we are as people and how we interact with the outside world. And I've explored this through a series of very intricate anatomical sculptures merged with oddities of nature. And this is also the first time I've exhibited some photographs, which was quite unexpected. When I started ceramics, I wasn't planning to do photography, which would be a part of the practice, but I've been in love with the medium for a very long time, and it just very naturally came together. And the photographs here kind of combine my love for ceramics and photography.
It's actually the first all-women's exhibition that the Museum of Goa is hosting. It has six artists. There are different themes that have been covered throughout the exhibition. We have themes from home, from identity, about Goa's nature, about just their own personal life, the trauma that some of them went through. And I think it's really, we're inviting all of you to come and join us here. The exhibition is going to be open until 31st of March, with several workshops happening from Raku to Opvara, and also a pop-up which will conclude the show on the 31st. So looking forward to having all of you here.
So I've moved to Goa 3 years back, and I feel that, you know, there is a lot of change that has happened that I have seen in these 3 years. A lot of people moving into Goa, which is then changing the entire way everyone is looking at different works, and a lot of artists over here, which kind of makes it very varied and interesting, exciting for people to see also. So I think it's a great place to be.
So honestly, it's been very helpful for me because I've just moved here, and Serendipity, Goa Open Arts, they've been very open and accessible for artists, and it's great for people to who move here for a little peace and quiet, because you can't get that in the cities. But I'm also close to some locals now, and they're not always very happy about it. So I do hope that when artists come here, they live here responsibly and they don't just stay in their own bubble, but they try to interact with locals, what's going on. I try to do that so that you guys don't hate me and want me to leave. And I really hope other people do that as well, because we don't want to take over Goa. We like it the way it is, and we want to keep it the way it is, so that we can all benefit from.
I think the post-pandemic awareness about Goa led to a huge influx of people from all over the world. And that also meant that all the creatives who are looking for a peaceful place and maybe a slower pace of life, they have all been coming to Goa and making their bases here. So the last couple of years in Goa has been a very buzzing art scene.
Well, as an art destination, I definitely think it's a very ideal location for the simple reason that the environment allows you to be able to develop whatever skills you have without getting involved with all the busyness of life, and you know, and the long monsoons, I think, helped me develop mine.
It was very nice, very warm and lovely. So many people have come and everybody's really interested and enthusiastic, so it's very nice to see.
I'm a young art practitioner. I started my ceramic work about 5 years ago, and even though my hair is grey, I'm still a very young art practitioner. If it wasn't for Goa, I don't think it would have happened. Even though I might have led a retired life, but I don't think places like Delhi and Bombay are really conducive for you to be able to.
I think there's a long way to go in terms of institutional support, and also creating that awareness within the public that art is actually, it can be a great way to not only to earn your livelihood, but also to bring light to the relevant issues which we are facing day to day, you know, from anything from social issues to natural disasters to your internal feelings. I think it gives us a medium to express ourselves, and I'm looking forward to what the Goa art scene is like in the next coming 5 to 10 years. It looks pretty exciting.
Goa has been lovely. It's a small city. It's very easy to get to know people. So it's a very close-knit network of artists, and people are very helpful and supportive, especially in a field like ceramics, in India, where sometimes information and resources are difficult to kind of get hold of. So we kind of help each other out in that sense.
At Morg, it's the most wonderful team, which makes it really effortless for you to put up stuff and put up your works and takes care of all the PR and advertising and encouraging people to come. And most importantly, it's the kind of people who come to Morg. There are people who are not necessarily artists or even art appreciators who makes it conducive for them to be able to come in here without being judgmental. So they can appreciate art and hopefully bring some of the art back, take some of the art back home.
It's excellent. Look at how many people have come today, and there's so many amazing things that happen here. And it's also very inspiring as an artist to live in Goa.
So basically, I think the whole our endeavor at the Museum of Goa is to ensure that art reaches everybody. It is to ensure that we make contemporary art accessible to all. And I think we started off with 6 people visiting us 8 years back. And today we have 300 people visiting us today. And I think slowly, Goa is known for several things. But I think Goa's culture is not that known. And I think our idea of telling Goa's story, Goa's history through art is why people are reaching out to us, why people are coming here to see us, and it's definitely going to evolve into a space where more and more people will come and get to know about Goa from a very different angle and through art.